Hi everybody, I'm back. You will be wondering that you saw me in the first chapter, same place, same dress, same cap, although I change them every day. You can catch me if it's the same repeat video by the same dress. Because if the date changes, my dress changes, my color changes, my suspenders change, my tie changes, my cap changes, and I won't tell you the color of my underwear, okay? So let's start. Here we are, chapter number 2, Getting Information. Wow, my pet subject. I'll be really speaking on this. Forget for what reason it is. Forget it is customer service. Forget you are a telephone operator. Forget you are an executive in some company. Forget you are an engineer or a doctor or a scholar. Information. What age are we living in now? You lucky people, you are young people, you have not seen our past. There, where we used to wait for a telegram, we would take months to get some information across the seas about our families. We would not know what's going on there. One sentence in that telegram would either boost our morale or drop us down, would make us go into depression. Telegrams were a signal of some bad news. People would be afraid when there was a telegram. Then there were no faxes there. There were no TV. Even radio started slowly with those big walls. You must have seen they were like big boxes. And we used to we used to put our ear next to radio. The whole family would get together just to listen to a serial or a drama to come. You people are lucky you are in the information age. At a click of a button, you get the information which somebody takes 20 years to learn through their schooling. At a tip of a button, you just press click and there you are. Not only with the written media, you have videos. I mean, this is a fantastic age. Don't waste your time. Don't sleep and just let the time go by. Because by the time you wake up for the next chapter, believe me, you would have missed out half of your life. It's so fast. Every minute things are changing. Every minute something new is coming. But please, I'm cautioning you. I don't mean by this that you get all the information which is coming in. You have to have a screen. You have to have a switch to switch off information you don't need. Because there is a word known as information overload. That could make you go crazy. You could freak out, you could have a nervous breakdown. Please, information getting is what you require for your job, for whatever profession you are. You send any top rated interior decorator, for example, and tell them I need this and this and this type of decoration, interior for my visualized building or whatever construction job that is. Do you think that maybe the world renowned architect or that interior decorator will just flip up his charts and start making those designs? No, he needs information. You have given them an idea of what you want, but he will go and check the ground, he will check the water level, he will check the atmosphere, he will check the air pressure, the facing of your project, whether it's facing the sun, it's west, east, or the roads, the surroundings. All that information is required to give you a solid project, a solid building. Now, because we need information, for what reason? Are we making a structure or just a room or a building? No, the information they require is the human interaction. Human factor is each and everywhere because we are humans. I'll give you an example. One architect was given a project, he had to make a construction. Everything went very smooth. The lawn outside, he made the lawn, but he did not put any flat stones, any pedestrian crossings there. So the owners, they stopped their payment. They said, no, you have not finished your job. Why didn't you put any pedestrian crossing through the lawn? He said, that I will do after 2 months. They said, why? We have to pay you now. Your project is over. Why are you giving us more 2 months to finish it? He said, that is where the human factor comes in. I want to see from where these people will cross the lawn to go to your front door. I can make squares, I can make lines, I can put it according to my wishes, but they may not use it. They're not necessary, they will go straight and then left and then go to your door. They will take the shortest route, shortest line which goes to your door, and they will ruin your lawn. If you don't make these properly, you must have seen many lawns, there is a print where people are walking through that. The grass starts dying in that area. He said, I will see this first, where they are crossing, then I will put the flagstones in that proper place. You cannot force these people to only use your flagstone, they can cross the lawn. This gives you an idea of what human factor is. Information gathering, you are on the phone, and suppose you are booking a table at a restaurant, okay? Suppose your boss or your family or for yourself, you need to take your guest out for a restaurant dinner. You pick up the phone, you call the restaurant. You say, what is on today? They say, today is our vegetarian day, or today is our Italian dishes day, whatever it is. Okay, you agree with it, it's very nice. What is on the menu today? And through those, is that an a la carte or is that a buffet? They will say this and this, whatever it is. Seating capacity, how many seatings do you have? Are you going to ask them that? No, you will only ask about your menu. And where will they place you? Is there a window seat? Is there a scenic place? The price you are not discussing there, because price is embarrassing. You can't tell them is it $30, it is $50, it's $100. You're not ordering that because of the money. It's because you have to impress somebody. Now, you think that information you got is enough? You have made a reservation, that's it? No. Get as much information as you can. Is this their most popular day? Is this their most rush hour? What time does their dinner start? What type of people inhabit that place? What is their clientele? Are they catering for Europeans? Mostly are there locals, Emiratis coming to that place? And what type of ambience does it have? Do they have photographs on their website? You can have to see that. Maybe I'll tell you one thing, if you're going to impress somebody, it's all psychological. You have to prepare for each and every event, every thing which comes up to impress that person. Is you have to see the color scheme of that restaurant. What color, maybe that color will clash with your. Some people have very, very sensitive feelings about colors, about music, about sound. Creative people especially, artistic people. If suppose that wall or the background of that restaurant is dark green, and if you are a lady, you are entertaining somebody or you are impressing somebody, maybe you are for your job, it's an interview, you are entertaining them, that green will rub off on your skin and you will look sick. Pale, it will wash out, it's not the right place for you. Suppose they have the green color, I don't know the shade, there is a green color which calms you down. There is a hue in green. That green is used in prisons, in hospitals, in psychiatric wards. Now, not because you're crazy, that's why you need to use. It calms you down. Police stations, they also have that green. Because they don't want people to freak out and start shouting and all. It calms you down, it saves their job, it reduces their stress which they face. What type of seating do they have? What is the color of, what type of damask tablecloths or wash tablecloths or starch tablecloths, cutlery and all. Of course you cannot get this thing on the phone, you may go to that place. You may ask other people's opinion. That's how it is. That's another chapter I'm coming to is the reviews of hotels and organizations, how much they matter, other people's opinion about your place, that will either break you or make you. So you check the reviews of that restaurant or hotel. If those people are happy, they are recommending that place, it could be good, because your life, your future depends on that. It's not just a dinner you're going, taking somebody out. Your future hangs on that. So you have to get as much information as you can. Don't just stick to the menu. It's just a dinner. We have to sit on a table. Every hotel has a table. Every restaurant will provide you the cutlery, the linen, the napkins. No, you have to see the ambience. Where is it? A candlelight dinner? I have tell you one place I went to, there was a candlelight dinner. We were getting married, it was my wife I had taken there. We were very excited. It was in Saudi Arabia, where they don't know about candlelight dinners and these things. And believe me, the candlelight was there, but the lights, floodlights on the ceiling were also on. They could not switch them off. They said, this is how it is. This is, our restaurant is like this. We cannot switch off these lights. Then why have you put a candle on the table? Why do you call it a candlelight dinner? Because there is a candle on the table, it's candlelight dinner. That atmosphere was not there. It was a washout, believe me. But my wife, thank God, was very understanding. In fact, she still jokes about it with me. So what I'm trying to tell you, think about many things. These vibrations, these feelings, everybody cannot provide. You have to, even if you ask them, how is your vibration there? What are your ambience? They will laugh at you. Maybe you are some spiritualist, maybe you are some kooky type of guy. They will not understand. You have to get this information, glean it out of them. First of all, the way the answers are being given, the way they are interacting with you, that tells you a lot about them. The training they have given to those people, the feeling of that people. Are they there just from 9 to 10 or maybe from 8 to 5? They're just looking at their watch and they're doing a duty as if it's a compulsive thing they have to do? Or are they, their heart in it? Are they really enjoying talking to you? Are they challenging themselves that you should not put down the phone without making a booking? Are they challenged with that? You can feel it in their voice. You can feel it the way they are trying to attract you. They're giving you all the surprises that you don't hang up the phone. So this does for the chapter number 2, and then we'll go to the next chapter.